That's what's up. You gotta appreciate life, you know? I just turned 47 on Sunday. But you know, you definitely gotta appreciate life, man. Because as you get older, you know, you just start to realize a few things. Like, I'm starting to realize that a lot of things just not fair. You know, like, I don't think it's fair that people with bad hygiene can't smell themselves.
Man!
You know what I'm saying? I mean, that cat with the bad breath, you know, or musty, they just can't seem to smell themselves. That shit is not fair, you know? I don't think it's fair that people that wear outfits that they shouldn't wear can't see themselves, obviously, you know? Or they get in the mirror and they just become blind or shit, because they come out looking fucked up. I mean, a baby t-shirt, ladies, the baby shirts. You know, the baby shirts, that's, you know, crop top, baby shirts, however you want to call them. But it means that the baby tees there, it don't mean because you have six babies, you wear that shirt, you know. But like I said, I've been around a while, you know, 47 years. They said that my generation wasn't going to make it past the age of 16. So the way I look at it, hey, I'm almost triple my age, you know, I'm triple my life in seconds. You know, and yeah, with that, you know, kids, they just don't have what we had growing up. This new generation, these cartoons, they have one. Now, we had great stuff like cartoons. Right? How many people miss good cartoons? Yeah. You have to pay attention to those cartoons, though, because there was a lot of serious stuff going on with a lot of the cartoon characters, if you want to pay attention. Like, anybody ever notice that Snagglepuss was dating a motherfucker? Yeah. I mean, just who else talk like this? Exit stage one. He wore the little Roman hat with the little Roman skirt, little white girl gym shoes. And what did he do? He dressed his dog just like him, didn't he? Dog had the Roman hat, little skirt, little white girl gym shoes. And he'd always be trying to build that doomsday machine. He'd be like, I'm trying to build the extra 9 modulator. I want to blow up the world. And as soon as that doomsday machine wouldn't work, what'd he do? He'd stomp off like a little bitch, didn't he? He'd be like, oh, that burns me. You know, I mean, listen, those cartoons, man, there was some real adult stuff going on. Like, anybody ever noticed that Fred and Barney was the first drug dealers? Oh, yeah, the Flintstones. Fred and Barney, look at the first drug dealers. Oh, just think about it. Who else worked from sun up to sundown all day long slinging rocks and bowls? That's a drug dealer. Oh, yeah. You know, they was once on high for Mr. Slate, but you know they had to be using two at the same time because, you know, they never seemed to have enough money. You know, they was always trying to find some type of scheme to make some extra money, you know? So they were functioning crackheads. And later on, they started doing what? They started seeing the animals talk to them, right? You never noticed that the animals talk to them at all now? Some crackhead shit. Then later, it even got worse. They had a little Martian talking to them. Nobody seen that little Martian. Little Gazoo. Oh, it's hello, dum-dums. How are you, dum-dums, today? Oh, what are you doing today? What can you fuck up today, Fred and Barney? But, I mean, man, you had Popeye, for instance. Oh, that was a real dysfunctional ass cartoon. Popeye was another drug addict. That's spinach. Oh, yeah. A lot of people today, they gotta smoke their spinach every day, don't they? They can't function without it. And he turned super with that spinach, didn't he? I mean, he had to have that spinach. And Bluto was the first side nigga. Oh yeah, that side nigga. He was that side nigga that came out of jail looking for his girl. And she was always gonna be his girl no matter what. And I don't know what it was about Olive Oil, but her girl shit had to be lined in gold because they used to kill each other over that pussy, didn't they? I mean, they used to hit each other with trains and buses and fucking anvils and shit. I'm like, damn, what do she got? And she was suffering from anorexia. Just think about it, you've never seen olive oil eat shit. At all. She was straight up and down, 6 o'clock. No thrills, no frills, no humps, no bumps. She turned sideways in the shower, every drop of water I'm missing. And it was raising a crack baby. Sweetie? Just think about it. Top out wasn't his daddy. Olive oil wasn't his mama. Where the fuck did he come from? Yeah, that was one of our crackhead friends. Just dropped them off and they just took care of the little bastard. And you know he was a crack baby. Why? Because he could never go to sleep. Little fucker had too much energy, didn't he? 4 o'clock in the morning. Where is he at? He at the construction site and shit. He know everywhere. He all around town. It's like, damn, whose baby is this? But, you know, we had some cartoons that helped us out, too. Real educational cartoons. I know they're dragging through the mud right now, but give Bill Cosby a round of applause. Hey, you can't take that man genius away from him. Because he gave us that cartoon, and it told us every Saturday morning. But you know that he was teaching us with the slow class, right? Oh, yeah, Fat Albert and the Gang, that's the fucking slow class. Yeah, just think about it. What other class you know of kids ranging from the ages of 17 to 9? All of them in the same classroom, same damn teacher. None of them ever graduated, did they? Yeah. When was the Fat Albert graduation special gonna come on? That's what I always want to know. They never fucking graduated. But Fat Albert was a trip though. When you think about Fat Albert, just think about this. This dude had to be the smartest, but at the same time dumbest and nosiest motherfucker you ever met in your life, right? Because Fat Albert knew everything about everything about everybody. And somebody always come up with a little problem. You know, be a little girl sometimes, right? You ever notice that all the girls on Fat Albert had the same voice no matter what? No matter what color they are, they all had the same voice. They'll walk up and they'll say, "Hi, Fat Albert." He'd be like, "Hey, Sneakwood, how you doing?" She'd be like, "I'm fine, Fat Albert." That's when Fat Albert paid real close attention to little Sneakwood, right? He looking at Sneakwood, he looked right, he looked left, and he said, "Hey, Sneakwood, how'd you get that bruise on your left arm?" She'd be like, "I fell out, Fat Albert." Fat Albert get real smart and say, "Uh-oh, you can't get no bruise like that just from falling down. You've been child abused." Like, damn, how the fuck did you know that? But, like I said, I'm old school. I like a lot of old school things. I like old school actors as well. You know, a lot of them don't get enough credit. One of them that happened to be getting a drug through the mud right now is Morgan Freeman, right? Give it up for Morgan Freeman. Yeah. Oh, yeah. That brother's nice. But, you know, Morgan, when I got introduced to him, he came on a show called Electric Company. You know? Yeah. He was cool as fuck, though, when he came out, wasn't he? He come out with the little army jacket on with all the patches and shit. You don't know exactly what he did. He did about 3 tours. You know he got a purple heart. But he come out singing to you like, "Easy Reader, that's my name." I said, "And Easy Reading, that's my game." I said, But you ever notice that Morgan always been old than the motherfucker? He's been old since he came out. And one of the best things about him is that he does a lot of voiceovers now, right? So he does a lot of narration. Imagine if he narrated his own life story. Probably go a little something like this. Be like, "Hi, I'm Morgan Freeman, and I was born in the year of 1917. After the hour of 9:17, at the age of 17, that's right, I was singing high school from the day I was born." I think they're going to do a remake, you know, of the Benjamin Button story with him. You know, you ever seen that? Yeah, the Benjamin Button with the little pretty white boy named Brad Pitt. Remember, he was born old and he got young. The older he got, well, they're going to redo that with Morgan Freeman. Right? It's gonna be called the Leroy Jenkins story, starring Morgan Freeman. And he's just gonna be a black dude that was born old, and the motherfucker just got older and older and older. I ain't gonna spend too much more time up here with y'all. I'm gonna rock out with a couple of old school hip hop classics. Who miss good music, right? Good old school hip hop. So I'm gonna rock out for y'all. If y'all recognize these joints, I want y'all to just sing along. But I need a little crowd participation though. So on the count of three, if everybody can give me a hand clap, and on time, black people, a hand clap. On the count of three, I want to have a clap. So one, two, three, and clap. It was all a dream. I used to read my love magazine. So I put my head in the gear, and then I was reading. And it's what I was. Every Saturday, rapper track with some magic moment on. I let my teeth crack to my tape.
Yeah, check it out.